I'm going to go to the hospital. eternal God who leads us through all times, we give thanks to your holy name for bringing us to this moment of celebration. In joy for these young men and women who you have blessed us with in this school district, we pray your blessing upon this occasion. We praise your name as we honor these graduates for which you have given inquiring minds to seek knowledge, and that you have given groups of teachers, administrators, and school staff to point out the way to understand. For these, we give thanks. Loving Lord, who leads our coming and going, we stand at the threshold of the future and ask that your wisdom may guide these graduates to strive at new ventures. Show them the lessons for a full life, to share personal fulfillment, strengthen the nation, and lead us to lasting joy and inner peace. In wonder, we stand before you, wait your mysterious hand which knocks at the door and invites us into tomorrow. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen.
forth your best efforts in everything you do. You don't have to be a social worker or a minister to help or to have time to support others. Anyone can give their time to help. And this doesn't necessarily mean giving money to share, but rather by showing understanding to someone in time of need and being polite. And as a person gets older, they realize they get more joy out of helping others than accumulating wealth. I feel that a player on a basketball team that works hard to practice but doesn't get to play very much is just as much a part of the team as a team superstar. Because even though they won't receive honors or praises like a superstar, they still can be content in knowing that they give up their best. Same thing can be said of students who work hard in school but don't have the best grade point attitude. If they give their best, they can trust themselves. And just because certain occupations don't receive like the financial benefits and personal recognition of other occupations, this doesn't mean that those that engage in occupations aren't successful. Besides, as long as you do your best in all that you do, it doesn't matter what the rest of the world thinks. So you can never try to do it. So many times people are prejudiced and expect race, religion, or political beliefs, and other people decide what kind of person someone is, instead of using their own good judgment. One of the most influential groups of people on our thoughts of hearing others is the news media. We turn on the news tonight, believing everything they say as a true gospel, not wanting to think that if they refer to a certain group of people as bad, that it just might not be true. Another major influence on how we judge people by what others say was just like the news media uses preconceived ideas about other people. So by keeping our minds free of prejudice and forming our own opinions of others, we can maintain our sense of individualism. Another key to achieving success is being able to affect change. As it says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1, 2, and 4, everything which we seek and time with every person under the heaven. Time to be born, and time to die. Time to be, and time to die. Time to be born, and time to die. In other words, life will always be for the better. It will change for the better or for worse. But whatever changes in current life, it is the most successful that we want. We must live one day at a time, realizing that whatever happens today, you will always have tomorrow to look forward to. If you have dreams, don't be afraid to pursue them. If you believe in yourself and are willing to work hard, you can accomplish anything. Because just as it said in our state motto, God, all things are possible. In closing, I would like to thank all my teachers and wish my fellow classmates the best of luck in their future endeavors.
Camera.
For each of us, it has meant something different. Although in the past 13 years, we've shared many of the same memories, the ones that we keep in our hearts and in our minds are going to be different from the ones that someone else has kept. Looking back, I can remember there were a lot of things that we waited for at that high school with great anticipation. All these things were very special while they lasted, but now they're merely habits or good memories. As a freshman, I can remember I couldn't wait till I got my class rank. To me, that was the official symbol that I was now in high school. But now, it's just like another piece of jewelry in my jewelry box. Then as a sophomore, couldn't wait to get my license. I think we all felt that way. It seems to give us a small feeling of independence for the first time. But now, it's just a habit. Whenever I have to go somewhere, I just go out, jump in the car, and go without giving it a second thought. Then, as we became juniors, everything we did led towards prom. We worked very hard to have a good prom, but that too is over, and it's now just among our good memories. Then, before we knew it, we were seniors. We were at the top of the hill, and we loved it there. We looked forward to graduating. First, there was only one more year to get through. Then, before we knew it, one more month. And then finally, one more day. This year's flown by, but it has been one of the most memorable years in my life. All the things that have happened, I will cherish forever. I'm sure we can all remember, sometime in the past 17 or 18 years of our lives, someone asking us, probably many times, what are you going to do when you grow up? Or, what are you going to do with your future? Well, our future is here. And what are we going to do with it? Whether our future is college, a job, a family, or all three, one thing we can expect is that it'll be what we make it. I recently read this following quote in a magazine. It said, far away is far away, only if you don't live there. I think that same perspective can be applied to our lives. Goals will always be just goals. We don't work to turn them into accomplishments. Can life be all that we want it to be? Why not? Can life be great? Absolutely. Will we have to work hard to make it that way? You bet we will, but it will be worth it. Let's go through life anticipating things and living life to the fullest. The last thing I'd like to say is thanks. Thank you to all the administrators and to the teachers and our seniors. Thank you to our friends and our family for always being there for us. To thick and thin, you've given us support. I'd also like to say thank you to the class of 89. Thank you for being my friends for the past 13 years. I hope that you all find success and true happiness in all that you do. I think we should all be very proud that we were a member of the class of 1989.
Thank you. this immediate replacement for me at this time to recognize the top members of this graduating class. The class of 1989 has performed admirably, both in the classroom and all other extracurricular activities. They have set standards of achievement and benchmarks for the classes that follow. At this time, I would like to list some of the achievements of the students in this class. As I call your name, please stand and be recognized. And would you please hold your applause until all have been recognized? Daryl Adams, member of the National Honor Society. Shane Anderson, member of the National Honor Society, recipient of the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, the North Union Education Association Scholarship, the Millikan College ACT Scholarship. Stacy Anderson, member of the National Honor Society, recipient of the Kennedy Scholarship. Stacy Ag, member of the National Honor Society. Elmer Margash, member of the National Honor Society, recipient of the Brant Cunningham Memorial Scholarship. Sue Ellen Atherton, member of the National Honor Society. Greg Ballinger, recipient of the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Amanda Barnes, recipient of the Tri-Rivers Award of Distinction. Ginger Beckett, member of the National Honor Society. Mike Denner, member of the National Honor Society and recipient of the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Jeff Rittner, received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Tammy Caldwell, member of the National Honor Society. Janet Clark, received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Tom Clark, received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Jim Collins, Tri-Rivers North Union Student of the Year. Andy Crevison, received the Senior Service Award. Fred Cobb, received the Senior Leadership Award, the James Christopher Memorial Scholarship, the Richwood Merchants Art Scholarship, the Elks Student of the Year, the North Union Hall of Fame, is a member of the National Honor Society, and received a scholarship from Fairmont State University. Kurt Cunningham, member of the National Honor Society, recipient of the John and Martha McAfee Scholarship and the Kennedy Scholarship. Kathy Davis, member of the National Honor Society, recipient of the North Union Richwood Alumni Scholarship. Amy Evans, member of the National Honor Society, received the Ashland Oil Scholars Award, the Ohio State University Marion Albert Scholarship, the Mark Wells Memorial Scholarship, and the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Matt Primmel, member of the National Honor Society, and received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Harry Gage, member of the National Honor Society, received the Ohio State University Marion Parents Club Scholarship. John Galloway, member of the National Honor Society, received the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, the University of Charleston Centennial Scholarship. Rhonda Goodwin, member of the National Honor Society, received the Ohio Board of Regents Scholarship, the State Board of Education Award of Distinction, the Ohio Northern University Honors Scholarship, and the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Peggy Higginbotham received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Kelly Holbrook received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Michelle Jeffers received the State Board of Education Award of Distinction. Amy Kavanaugh received the Senior Dependability Award as a member of the National Honor Society and received the Kennedy Scholarship. Harry Fredahane is a member of the National Honor Society and received the Award of Regents Scholarship, the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, the Union County Bar Association Award, the Lloyd and Joy Kearns Memorial Scholarship, and the Cottonwood College Academic Scholarship. Vicki Busley receives the Junior Miss Scholarship. Ken Martin is a member of the National Honor Society and receives the Harry Wolf Memorial Scholarship. Matt Fingers is a member of the National Honor Society and receives the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Phil Mickle, member of the National Honor Society, receives the Ohio Corporate University Honor Scholarship, the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, the Lloyd and Joy Kearns Memorial Scholarship, the ELF Scholarship, and the FFA Scholarship. Stephanie Hipple, member of the National Honor Society, receives the State Board of Education Award for Distinction, the Bluffton College Presidential Scholarship, the Frederick Susskind Scholarship, the Rosemary Flynn Memorial Scholarship. Tina Nichol, member of the National Honor Society, received the Junior Miss Scholarship and the Kenny Scholarship. Tammy Macy received the Tri-Rivers Academic Award, the Tri-Rivers Achievement Award, the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, and is a member of the National Honor Society. John Fitz is a member of the National Honor Society. Jeff Price receives the Presidential Academic Fitness Award. Sherry Rack is a member of the National Honor Society. Joey Schultz, member of the National Honor Society, received the Senior Sportsmanship Award and the North Union Education Association Scholarship. Melissa Wells, member of the National Honor Society. Randy Wiley received the Sherman Wilson Memorial Award. Tim Wainfield receives the Presidential Academic Fitness Award, the Ohio State University Class of 1968 Memorial Scholarship, is a member of the National Honor Society, and received the FFA Scholarship. Tim Young, a member of the National Honor Society. The Class of 1989 has received over $30,000 in scholarships and grants. I would like to mention that over 9,000 of those dollars in scholarship money comes from our local community, and we're very proud of that. Let's give them a round of applause. At this time, it's just a pleasure to introduce the superintendent of the North Union Local School District, Mr. Tyrone Fox.
Thank you, Mr. Roller, members of the Board of Education, members of the faculty, honored guests, parents, and members of the graduating class of 1989. Tonight, I have a gift for you all. Very short. I'm keeping it short because I know how eager you are to get on with it. You're eager to get on and get those diplomas that you work so hard to achieve. You're eager to join your families and your friends to share with them. You're eager to start your plans for the future. And this is, should be, for this is graduation. Far from being the end, it's the beginning of all of your tomorrows. Over the past several years, you have worked, you've studied, practiced, and played, and grown mentally as well as physically. And I can attest to that physically because 4 years ago, I came into North Union as well as you came into North Union High School, and my first experience with this class was in football locker rooms 4 years ago, and I never saw such small football players in all my life. And that still goes with pictures that I have of these people today, but I can tell you what, they've grown both physically and mentally for that particular point in time. For some of you, this means job and responsibility and family living. For others, this will mean college and future years of study and preparation. Whatever course your future takes, it is my sincere hope that you will look back on these years that you've prepared to meet and to deal with the challenges of life that have presented itself. To you, the parents, I would like to quickly kind of give you some stats on this class, and we've already heard some overwhelming statistics. We have 42 of these young people that are going on to college. We have 5 that are going on to a trade technical school. We have 53 that are either seeking or have employment already. We have 8 that are going to join the military, and 3 that will be joining the homemakers. With that, we have a good synopsis of this class, what they've achieved, what they've done for you in these past 4 years. So on behalf of myself, the faculty, the staff of the North Carolina High School, I wish to each one of you the happiness of a productive life, the respect of your fellow human beings, the love of your family, and may the future be yours. The best to you, and congratulations to you, the class of 1989. Thank you.
Superintendent Thomas, Director Schwartz, Reverend Gage, parents, grandparents, relatives, and friends. Having completed all the requirements of the State of Ohio and the North Union Board of Education, I now present to you the ready to receive their diplomas, the graduating class of 1989. Mr. Dennis Schwartz, Director of the Tri-Rivers Career Center, will present vocational completion certificates to our students who have successfully completed their Tri-Rivers program. Ginger Diane Beckett.
Michael Andrew Benner. Jason Elton Bama. Pamela K. Wilson Brittlinger. Jeffrey Allen Brittlinger. Jeff Bryant. Melinda Sue Amrine Jr. Sheila Kathleen Boyer. Sherry Marie Boyer. Tammy Jo Caldwell. Jennifer Dawn Callahan. Robert Edward Cheney. Chad William Clark. Thomas James Clark. William J. Cochran. Charles W. Coleman. James Marion Collins II. Darren Lee Conley. Billy Joe Portal II. Amy Sue Garrison. Frederick Paul Brown. Kirk Patrick Cunningham. Catherine Ann Davis. Amy Ellen Evans. Stephanie Ann Ford. Jay Scott Foster. Matthew Thomas Frimmel. Eric Alexander Gay. John D. Galloway. Frida Irene Gibson. Rhonda K. Goodwin. Kevin Lee Gross. Roger Mace Hamilton. Peggy Marie Higginbottom. Kelly D. Holbrook. Michael Ray Huckabee. Michelle Lynn Jeffers. Kirkpatrick. Eric Ryan Brebehane. Nathan Dane Kyle. Dawn Michelle Lane. John E. Lazenby. Jill Elizabeth Leibel. Vicky Sue LeMaster. Greg Allen Liggett. Gerald Leon Lookaball. Vicky Marie Lusley. Kenneth William Marlin III. Matthew Christopher Mayers.
Amen.
Russell Allen McKinley. Chester Eugene Mills. Derek D. Mallory. Sean Kelly Neal. Philip Eugene Nichols. Stephanie Ann Nichols. Tina Renee Nichols. Tabitha Lee Pacey. Ted Junior Parrish. William Gregory Peck. Nikki Jo Norwood. Joffrey G. Fitz. Jeffrey Thomas Price. Sherry Lynn Rack. Kathy Sue Cole Roush. Douglas Wayne Reese. Robin Lynn Robinson. Jody Lynette Schultz. Melanie Jean Sellers. Brian E. Shoemaker. Lori Ann Smith. Thomas Dean Sullivan. Edgar Nelson Thompson. Michelle Lynn Thornburg. who are down on me. Melissa Hay Welsh. Randall M. Wiley. Tammy Annette Wilson. Marcus Charles Wilson. Timothy Joseph Winfield. Heidi Jo Wiseman. Candy Lee Warnstaff. Linda Louise Whitehall. Donna Christina Yates. Timothy J. Young. James Oscar Young. Thank you.
go on alone. The Lord is your spirit. Grace be with you.
Amen.